Yeah, okay.
Yeah, she went 3 years of, as a girl and came back as a young lady.
Crap, I got a phone somewhere.
You got a phone somewhere?
Good.
Hey, my luck, David.
It don't bother us.
Maybe she overslept, sometimes she did so. I know.
We have.
Six-thirty this morning when I got up.
Hey.
I'm fine.
Yeah, it's like.
David didn't do it.
So what do you think of the sunshine for a change?
Oh, it's wonderful. Yeah, it kind of feels weird.
Yeah, no, tomorrow
I'm not sure what it is.
It'll go back.
It'll go back to be
tomorrow. It'll go back.
I wish we'd go away for a while. The animals are in the mud up to the knees.
The sunshine or the rain?
The rain. He said it was coming back.
Yeah, it's coming back tomorrow.
Oh, exciting. My boots get stuck in the county.
They were underneath.
They just did a very good test.
Now she's going to come in barefoot.
Yeah, she stepped up. So one of these days we're going to get a text. We're going to get a text saying, I'm stuck.
I don't like this one. Uh-oh. Mm-hmm. Then try to get back in the booth.
Last year I had it so bad that it ripped the door when I pulled it out.
Mm-hmm. Well, that ain't good. We don't have to worry too much about that anymore.
It was nice while it lasted. When the snow comes up to your knees. Goes in the booth anyway.
Just up to your knees? I remember.
I know. We weren't in Buffalo, so we didn't get that.
Mm-hmm. It was supposed to be 100 in Vegas today.
No. We'll be.
That is a problem.
They can keep it.
That's not
true.
No, because I had dinner at
her house. I always have a hose running in the water.
He's old, he has no memory anymore.
Thank you.
Hey. Lincoln.
Uh-oh. Am I in trouble?
Nope, you're not in trouble.
Okay.
Should you be?
Yeah, I'm okay with October.
October 8th.
You know, you can get some warm. Really, temperature-wise, I kind of like it last week. I'm okay with it. Upper 60s, lower 70s, 40s. It's the rain.
Once it hits 85 or above, it starts to get too warm for me.
Yeah, it hits an 8 thing. And,
even like upper 70s.
I can start sweating in the 60s. Alright. Not only is this Memorial Weekend, this is also Trinity Sunday. This is also the 5th Sunday, so we're going to do a lot of singing today. So I hope you brought your voices, because if you're expecting me to lead, this is not going to sound good.
What is Trinity Sunday?
Trinity Sunday is the Sunday we celebrate the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, the Trinity.
Don't we celebrate them every Sunday?
No, actually we don't. Most of the time, we spend a lot of time on Jesus and a lot of time on God. We don't spend a whole lot of time on the Holy Spirit. But after the Ascension and Pentecost, then we have Trinity Sunday. Announcements. Of course, today, tomorrow's Memorial Day. There is a service at the Holden Cemetery. It will be at 10 o'clock. They put 10 o'clock in the paper for everybody, and it's usually at 9 o'clock, but we're having it at 10 o'clock because that's what the paper says.
If it doesn't rain, yes.
If it rains, we will not have it, but as far as I know, we will still have the get-together at the VFW.
You are?
As far as I know.
Yeah,
well,
they said they
weren't going to. Oh, they did? I'm just the commander. They don't tell me.
Holden Community News. They weren't going to do anything until January.
Really?
Something. Well, that's what I read.
Well, and like I said, the article in the paper, I don't know who gave that, because normally it's 9 o'clock we do the thing, and the paper said 10 o'clock. So.
Actually, they didn't say nothing.
You're talking about the breakfast that was supposed to be.
The breakfast that's usually after it, which would now be 10:30 instead of 9:30. The monthly breakfast they did cancel, yes. The monthly breakfast they did cancel. So they did cancel that. The next Sunday is Communion Sunday, and I'm planning on kind of going back to what we used to do.
What's that?
I know it's been a long time. It's been over a year. I'm gonna have to figure out how to do it.
Coming up brunch.
Yes.
I like that. Thank you.
I mean, with everything opening up, and I'm like, it's time.
Do we want to talk about when we want to have our June club?
We should probably talk about that.
What makes a difference if Father's Day is on the 18th or the 20th?
Father's Day is on the... Why does it say 18th?
18th.
Should be the 20th.
Put it up there. Wow.
It's the 20th.
It's the 20th.
You need to talk to whoever did your
I got to talk to my secretary.
I agree.
It's the 20th. Yeah, I don't know why it's...
See, and that's when...
Maybe it was 18th last year or something.
Maybe I was telling you that Chuck has to have guard on the 18th.
So, I'm getting ready. Typically, we would have done it on the 13th, but because of annual conference...
We'll be here.
We'll be doing the video thing. What are we going to do for church that day?
We're going to be doing the video.
Everybody?
No. Just those doing the conference, you're doing the conference video thing. Those who come to church are doing the church video.
Who's going to
preach?
Probably Nate. Burger King.
That's what we got planned for.
I guess we could attempt to have it next Sunday.
That's the question. Do we want to do it on Father's Day?
Next Sunday would be the 6th.
Yeah. Oh, next Sunday.
It isn't. You got to be on the computer because the
that's the 13th, which is our normal Sunday for eating and stuff. So the question is, do you want to do it next Sunday after Communion or Father's Day?
Next Sunday.
It's in the middle of the week.
Let's do it next Sunday.
I agree.
Okay.
So you can leave your barbecue up here so we can do hot dogs and hamburgers. And everybody just
bring. I would hate it.
Why?
It's not that big.
Okay.
Well, we'll have hamburgers. There, Ruth.
Hey.
Hi.
I snuck in.
I'll bring pasta salad and
okay.
All right. Okay.
Yeah, we have hamburger at home, so, right?
Yes.
Okay, we can bring hamburger. So we need somebody to bring hot dogs and everybody to bring chips, side salads, fun stuff.
I'll bring the hot dogs.
Dessert.
Okay.
I'll bring some buns.
She'll bring some buns.
Okay.
Alright.
I'll bring some macaroni salad.
Alright. Cool.
I'll put out a messenger and y'all can tell me what everybody's bringing, okay?
Then, the day after Father's Day is when Vacation Bible School is at Woods. Them three, no. Lincoln's going to be gone, but her three and his other one.
Is that one VBS?
That's what VBS is, Vacation Bible School.
Dad.
It is from 6 to 8, I believe.
Ruth asked if you need supplies.
Do they need supplies like craft
kind of
stuff or just anything like that?
At this point, no. Actually, I may be late next Sunday, so because we're supposed to talk about it after church. So I will know more after next Sunday. So I might be a little late.
We'll
I
should be late.
You don't start now. You don't need me.
We'll wait for you.
So.
Yeah,
you don't need me. Go ahead and start.
I think we can go ahead and start. There'll be plenty of food.
Bible study this week is at Hama, 5 o'clock, for our monthly volunteer. You do that. They've had some people, and the word is starting to get out. So that's the whole thing.
I saw the guy that used to be over at.
Chet?
Yeah, I saw him in the grocery store the other day. Man, he just hugged me and hugged me and hugged me.
He's happy because they're back in church now.
Yeah. Yep.
Church of Christ finally let them go back to church. Community of Christ.
It's all the same to me.
We're all Christians.
I'm sorry, Lord.
Birthdays, I don't have anything listed this week. Does anybody know of any birthdays, anniversaries? Any other announcements we need to make? Okay, cool. Let's bow our heads for opening prayer. Oh God, keep our whole country under your protection. Wipe out sin from this land and lift it up from the depth of sorrow. O Lord, our shining light, save us from deep grief and misfortune. Bless us with your wisdom so that the poor may not be oppressed and the rich may not be oppressors. Make this a nation having no ruler except God and a nation having no authority but that of love. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. All right. Our praise song.
We need some candles.
They light them during the praise song.
What? Anyway, let's sing our praise song. Proof of Your Love by For King and Country. You flustered me a little. Let's stand up. You want to stand every time we sing? You'll be standing a lot today.
You don't have love. I waste my breath with every song I bring. An empty voice, a hollow noise. If I speak with a silver tongue, convince a crowd that don't have love, I leave a bitter taste with every word I say. So let my life be the proof of your love. Let my love look like you and what you're made of.
How you live, how you die,
let me be the proof of your love.
We believe that it conquered death.
don't want to go ahead and do the doxology?
No. And you don't do the doxology after the creed you go to a doctor.
No, but I just figured that was one more thing where we...
I know, I could have done that. I didn't throw it in. But maybe just, next time I'll...
just, you know...
As long as you're standing, right?
Right. Let's get all the standing over.
All right. I do have some Bible readings today for Trinity Sunday. First is from Isaiah 6, verses 1 to 8. It says, "In the year that King Uzziah died, I saw the Lord high and exalted, seated on a throne, and the train of his robe filled the temple. Above him were seraphim, each with six wings. With two wings they covered their faces, with two they covered their feet. And with two they were flying, and they were all calling to one another, 'Holy, holy, holy is the Lord Almighty. The whole earth is full of his glory.' At the sound of their voices, the doorposts and thresholds shook, and the temple was filled with smoke. 'Woe to me,' I cried, 'I am ruined, for I am a man of unclean lips, and I live among a people with unclean lips. And my eyes have seen the King, the Lord Almighty.' Then one of the seraphim flew to me with a live coal in his hand, which he had taken with tongs from the altar. With it he touched my mouth and said, 'See, this has touched your lips. Your guilt is taken away and your sin atoned for.' Then I heard the voice of the Lord saying, 'Whom shall I send? And who will go for us?' And I said, 'Here I am. Send me.'" The word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
We've all kind of been called to go out for God. And we're planning on doing it, right? We're going to do it next Sunday since we changed our thing. Yeah.
Well, we can.
Sure, I think we ought to. This weekend we honor those who got called or volunteered for their country and died. So let's, when we go out, keep them in our minds as well. Let's sing now hymn number 364, "Because He Lives." We have some hymns, we have some songs, we have some hymns. We're going to do a lot of back and forth today.
Feel the pride and joy. Jesus, looking for the world to see, nobody but Jesus.
actually written with somebody in mind. John the Baptist. And Mark Hall explains why they wrote it. He says, when people came to him and wanted to know who he was, they were dropping rock star names of the time like Elijah and Moses and Abraham. But he didn't even tell them who he really was. He just said, I'm a nobody. I'm just a voice in the wilderness. He wasn't saying that because he was spiritual. He was saying that because he understood that telling people about himself wasn't going to do anything. But he had to tell people about the one coming after him. And that kind of goes well with Because He Lives, because that was a hymn written about 60 years ago, and it was about Jesus defeating death for us, because we're nobodies. But he came for us, no matter who we are. So, I thought that was kind of cool. Quentin?
David, the rest of the money's in the
your blessings on these tithes and offerings. And we ask that you multiply them so that we can go out and spread your word, just like those nobodies going out and telling everybody about you. Amen. Cue. Your birthday. You guys have a cake?
Yeah.
Is it usually a special cake? So how many candles do they put on the cake? As many as your age. I'm going to ask a really tough question. How many candles would go on my cake next year? I'll take 54. Next year, even your father can't add. It'll be 59.
She'll have
13. 13? Yeah, she'll have 13 on hers. That's right.
Eight?
No, she'll be teenager.
I know. That's very fair. Well, we're going to talk a little bit about this guy called Nicodemus. Nicodemus was talking to Jesus one time, and Jesus said that the only way to get to heaven is to be born again. Nicodemus didn't quite understand what he was talking about. Do you know what he was talking about?
63 candles.
Who?
59.
For me?
No. I think I screwed up around the 1960s.
You probably did. That was a bad time anyway.
When you go to heaven, you want to be born.
Yeah. Hmm. Jesus was talking about being born again down here. So you can get that. That makes no sense. That's what Nicodemus thought. He said, that really makes no sense. But he was talking about... Yeah. He was talking about... That's what Nicodemus thought. He thought, that's impossible. But Jesus wasn't talking about a human birth. He was talking about a birth through the Holy Spirit.
Now
you get it. I'm glad you get it, because there's a lot of people that really don't get it. Because when you're born of this Holy Spirit, you're born into a whole new life, aren't you? Because you're brought into what? What happens when you, the Holy Spirit, enters you?
Yeah, but you don't start out with this thing.
Yeah, don't. You become part of God's family.
Yeah. Everybody.
You're adopted into God's family. And that's what Jesus was talking about. Is there other ways to show your birthday? What else do we do for your birthday?
We go places. Don't start out.
No, you don't start. I don't. Well, see, here's the thing. I don't know. I won't know until I get there.
Hopefully,
that
means you
don't
start.
Well, you might start out with little wings.
Might start out with the
actual. Yes. Start out as a guardian angel, and then I want you to help.
How about putting a mark on the wall to see how tall you've grown in the last year? Did parents do that?
We did that.
You did that?
Yeah, we
did that at the old house.
Yeah, we do that because...
But it's at Gigi's house.
I feel like it might be over 40.
It's at your house. You've got that ruler on the wall?
Yeah, it's still
not good. You guys are just not having too much. But how do we check our growth as Christians? By the love we show for other people. Okay? So the more love you show, the more that they know you're a Christian. And the more the Spirit comes out of you. Okay? Being born again is... always trusting God.
That's like the children come to
me.
You know what that means?
Wait, what's that mean?
Means trusting God upstairs.
That means Jesus wants everybody. Not just the adults who think they know everything, but he wants the children who are still young and innocent. He wants everybody. That's what it means. And the Holy Spirit wants to be in everybody so that everybody can show love. So that everybody can be filled and adopted into God's family. Okay? Make sense? So being born again, like I said, doesn't mean being born like you were 13 years ago. But it means being born again into God's family. Okay? Let's pray. God, sometimes it's hard to understand what a new life that you offer to us is like. We thank you for sending Jesus to help us understand that, to help guide us. And we thank you for sending the Holy Spirit so that we can be born again in this new way of life. And it's in Jesus and the Holy Spirit's name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Wow, you ran on by the candy. I can't believe that.
Oh,
it's like, wait a minute. Our next song. Ruth Cake. She heard it one day. Teresa said she loved the song. I remember hearing the song. I really liked the song. So let's sing Gospel Song by Rhett Walker.
I can listen to the word, I can listen to my problems. and it's true. I can use a reminder.
Trinity Sunday. Inspired him to write the song Gospel Song. because he just loved playing the songs over and over. And that cheered him up and kept him from going stir crazy, you know, being cooped up like we all were last year. Our New Testament reading comes from Romans 8, verses 12 to 17. It says, "Therefore, brothers and sisters, we have an obligation, but it's not to the flesh to live according to it. For if you live according to the flesh, you will die. But if by the Spirit you put to death the misdeeds of the body, you will live. For those who are led by the Spirit of God are the children of God. The Spirit you receive does not make you slaves, so that you live in fear again. Rather, the Spirit you receive brought about your adoption to sonship. And by Him we cry, Abba, Father. The Spirit Himself testifies with our spirit that we are God's children. Now, if we are children, then we are heirs, and heirs of God and co-heirs with Christ. If indeed we share in His sufferings in order that we may also share in His glory." The Word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
From the heart.
Today I'm telling you about the meaning of the flag that's draped on the coffin and how they fold it and what the folds mean. The first fold is a symbol of life. The second is a symbol of belief in eternal life. Third is honoring the veterans departing. Fourth represents us, the citizens, in trusting with God. Five, tribute to our country, believing in our country and our flag. Six, it's the heart that we pledge to the flag. Seven is the tribute to the armed forces because they protect the country and our flag. Eight, it is tribute to the one who enters into the valley of the shadow of the death that we might see the light of day. Nine is the tribute to women and mothers, for through them we have the love, loyalty, and devotion and character of the men and women that serve this flag. And 10 is the tribute to Father, for He has given His sons and daughters in the defense of their country. 11 represents the lower part of the seal of King David and King Solomon and the glories in the new view, whose eyes, and God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. 12 represents the emblem of eternity and the glorious in the Christians. 13, older when the flag is completely folded, the star is uppermost, reminding them the nation's motto, "In God we trust." After the flag is completely folded and tucked in, it takes on the appearance of a cocked hat, ever reminding us of the soldiers who served under George Washington and the sailors and Marines also served under Captain John Paul Jones, who were followed by their comrades and shipmates in the armed forces of the United States, preserving for them the rights and privileges and freedoms they enjoy today and the freedoms we enjoy today.
Thanks, Pam. Anybody else? This next one, "I Know Who Holds Tomorrow," came from Peggy Perman. And she said it was one of Gary's dad's favorites. Although it's not that old. He must have just fell in love with it when it came out. But "I Know Who Holds Tomorrow" is not in the hymnal, so we'll have to sing it from.
I don't borrow from this sun.
Next one is an oldie but a goodie. Pam likes this. God's not dead. Which kind of, in my opinion, goes with the one we just sang.
Resurrection somehow. scripture reading for this is from John 3, verses 1 to 8. It says, "Now there was a Pharisee, a man named Nicodemus, who was a member of the Jewish ruling council. He came to Jesus at night and said, 'Rabbi, we know that you are a teacher who has come from God, for no one could perform the signs that you are doing if God were not with him.' Jesus replied, 'Very truly I tell you, no one can see the kingdom of God unless they are born again.' 'How can someone be born when they are old?' Nicodemus asked. 'Surely they cannot enter a second time into their mother's womb to be born.' Jesus answered, 'Very truly I tell you, no one can enter the kingdom of God unless they are born of water and the Spirit. Flesh gives birth to flesh, but the Spirit gives birth to the Spirit. You should not be surprised at what I am saying. You must be born again. The wind blows wherever it pleases. You hear its sound, but you cannot tell where it comes from or where it is going. So it is with everyone born of the Spirit.'" And God adds blessings to the reading of His word. This is one of my favorites. It makes Teresa cry. I get close. This is Memorial Weekend, and like I said, this is my favorite. Sing along.
This is where I'd settle down. I thought I'd die an old man back in my hometown. They gave me this plot of land, me and some other men, for a job well done. There's a big white house that's on a hill just up the road. The day they brought me home, they folded up a flag and gave told my mom and dad, "We're proud of your son. And I'm proud to be on this peaceful piece of property. I'm on sacred ground and I'm in the best company. I'm it to Arlington.
We're going to close with a song that was written between World War I and World War II in hopes of peace. Number 437, this is my song. That one just gives me chills every time I hear it.
Yeah. It's like the green, green grass, huh?
Weekend, driving, visiting, boating. I had a drowning on Lake the Ozarks last night. So we just need to keep all of those in our prayers. How's Will doing?
Starts radiation probably the second week in June. Has a podiatry appointment, so we'll find out about the deal with his heel.
Linda?
Chuck in at Yo's Brothers. That poor guy's in terrible shape. I don't know how he's working.
Jan?
Today is my sister-in-law's 87th birthday.
Debbie?
with joy because my dad was going to have to not do anything because the lady made it sound so horrible. But now we get to try to save him.
Ruth?
Joy that I'm now officially retired.
Yay!
And my concern is a prayer for those with mental illness.
Amen.
Definitely. Linda?
Continued prayers for Matthew, Ruth, and their family.
Thank you.
Days, military and veterans who commit suicide.
It's an average 22 every day.
That is horrible.
There's no.
We're back to the first mental.
Yep.
Let's bow our heads. Father, we bring many, many concerns and some joys to you this morning. Lord, we lift up all of our military and our first responders. Keep them safe as they do their job to protect us and our freedoms. But Lord, we need help with 22 a day in the military and the countless others who are suffering from mental illness. Lord, give us the strength to help them and guide them to us so that we can help them. Be with Chuck and Kathy and Will, Linda, Cindy, all those who have illnesses or healing, preparing for treatments. Lord, just be with them. Guide the doctors, the nurses, the therapists. Put your healing touch on all of them. Lord, we thank you for many things in our lives, for birthdays, for the military who protects us, for retirements, for new jobs. And we just ask that you be with all of those going through changes, that their new experiences are guided by you and done with you in their hearts. Lord, we thank you for good health. We thank you for birthdays, anniversaries. Lord, we ask that you be with all those this weekend as we remember those who died to protect our freedoms. But we ask that you be with all those who are out celebrating. Keep them safe, especially those on the waterways, not only in Missouri, but around the world. Lord, we pray all these things, all the stuff that we talked about, but all the things that are still in our hearts that we didn't mention out loud. We lift them up to you. We give praise to you for the good, and we lift up the concerns. And we do all this along with the prayer that your Son taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever.
Love y'all, but I gotta go.